Question 61 asks that from a mating of a two dihybrid individual, that is capital A small a capital B small b and capital A small a capital B small b. Now these two dihybrid are mated. How many of the 16 possible zygote combination would be expected to contain only two dominant alleles? How many will contain two dominant alleles? Now, if you make a cross, you know that total 16 combination will appear. Now, what are the possible genotype which can have a two dominant allele? Suppose there can be capital A and small b. This is also having a two dominant allele or two dominant genes. Okay, then small a, capital B, that can also be a dominant allele. Then capital A, capital B, that can be also a dominant allele. Okay. So now, such type of genotypes are one. Such type of genotype are possible are also one, and such type of genotype are four. So 4, 1, and 1, that is 6 combination, 6 zygotes are there. That zygotes have two dominant genes. So that is option D is the correct answer. Question 62 asks that multiple alleles are present. Now multiple alleles are present at the same of locus of the chromosome, that is option A, at same locus of the chromosome. So it is correct, obvious it is present at the same locus. Option B is given as on the non-sister chromatid. No, it is present on the non-sister chromatids. Yes, it can be present on the non-sister chromatid of homologous chromosome. But we can't say, because option is given just non-sister chromatid, and non-sister chromatid of heterologous chromosome can be there. So it cannot be the answer. Option C is given as on different chromosome. Now on different chromosome. So on different chromosome, if we take that different chromosome, if we consider homologous, then there can be there. But if we consider heterologous or non-homologous, then it cannot be there. So in with respect to non-homologous chromosome, on different chromosome, the multiple alleles can be there, cannot be there, because multiple alleles are present on the homologous chromosome. And option D, at a different loci, there cannot be at different loci. That cannot be possible because it is present on the same loci. So it is incorrect. So A is the correct answer. Question 63 asks that how many different kinds of gamete will be produced? How many different type of gametes will be produced by a plant having a genotype? Plant having a genotype capital A, capital B, capital C. Now in this heterozygous is 1, so the formula is applied, that is 2 power n, n is equal to heterozygous condition, that is a power 1. So 2 types of gametes will be formed, and these 2 types of gametes will obtain from this. They are capital A, capital B, capital C, and another one is the capital A, small b, capital C. These two type of gamete can be formed. So option is the 2 is the correct answer, that is option A. Next is question 64. Question 64 asks that a plasmid. So plasmid, you know that it is a extra chromosomal self-replicating double-stranded circular DNA. So it replicates independently. So if we go with the option A says that it lives together with the chromosome. No, it does not live with the together with the chromosome. It is independent. Option B shows a dependent assortment. No, it does not show a dependent assortment. C can replicate independently. Yes. And D is given as cannot replicate. It can replicate. So C is the correct answer, that it can replicate by its own. Next is question 65. Question 65 asks that linkage was first observed in. It was first observed in Lathyrus odoratus, and this Lathyrus odoratus is known as sweet pea. So B option is the correct answer. Question 66 asks that frequency of Down syndrome increases when the maternal age increases So if we talk about the Down syndrome, the occurrence is 1/1700 birth at age 25 years. If the age of the mother is 25 years and the at 25 years the birth, if 1700 occurs, then the one can be affected. But if the age of the mother is 40 years, then the chances of birth, that is 1 in 100 birth. If the age become 45 years, then the chances is 1 in 10 for the woman of the age. This one, so 1 out of 10 birth can have a disease. So with the increase in age, the chances of Down syndrome increases, and it is asking increases when the maternal age is beyond. So option is above 35 years, below 35 during first pregnancy, and mother at least 3 children. So according to best appropriate option is option A, that is above 35 years. So A is the correct answer. Question 67 asks that in plant, red fruit is dominant over yellow fruit. Red fruit is dominant over yellow fruit. So R is dominant over small r, and the tallness is dominant over shortness. If the plant with the genotype, that is capital R capital T small t, is crossed with the plant that is a small r small t, now the phenotype of this is a red and tall, and here yellow and short. Now the gamete which are produced by this capital R capital T small t is capital R capital T and capital R small t. And the gametes which are produced by here, that is our small r small t. Now if we make a cross of this, it is capital R small r capital T small t, and if we make a cross of this, this is capital R small t. Now this is red and tall again, and this is red and short. So red and tall and red and short are in the, so 50% are, 75% will be tall with red, no 50% are there, because 1:1 ratio is there. Option B is all the offspring will be tall with the red fruit, no, tall with the red fruit, because some 50% are short, so it is incorrect. C option is 25% will be tall with the red fruit, no 50% are off, and option D is given as 50% will be tall with red fruit. So it is the most appropriate answer, that is option D. Question 68. Question 68 asks that a tall true breeding garden pea plant, tall true breeding garden pea plant is crossed with the dwarf true breeding garden pea plant. When a F1 plant, so the gametes are capital T and here gamete is small t, and F1 will be obtained, that is capital T small t. This is the P generation, this is the F1 generation. The F1 plant gets self, so it is a tall. Now if selfing is occurred, then capital T small t crosses with the capital T small t, and progeny will be obtained, that is a capital T capital T capital T small t capital T small t and small t small t. Now in this, if we go with the option, the ratio is 1:2:1, that is a homozygous tall is to heterozygous tall and the homozygous dwarf. So C is the correct answer, that is the ratio is 1:2:1. Question 69 asks that match the following in which column 1 is there and column 2 is there. Column 1 is asking, that is first option is inheritance of two gene. Inheritance of two gene. Second is incomplete dominance. Third is codominance. And fourth is inheritance of one gene. Now if we match with the column 2, in column 2 inheritance of two gene matches with the option R, that is 9:3:3:1. Now incomplete dominance matches with the option Q, that is 1:2:1. Codominance, that is asking about option P, that is a ABO blood group. And inheritance of one gene, that is a S 3:1. So RQPS, now we take it as a, okay, so according to this, option C is the correct answer. Question 70 asks that chromosome number in a cell of flowering plant is, chromosomal number in a cell of flowering plant is. Now the chromosome number, if we say in a flowering plant, they are haploid in germinal cell, they are diploid in somatic cell, and triploid in endosperm cell. So it can be haploid, diploid and triploid. So answer is option C, that is of many type. So C is the correct answer. Question 71 asks that what type of gametes will form by a genotype capital R small r, capital Y small y. Now the four types of gametes will be formed, that is a capital R capital Y, capital R small y, small r capital Y, and small r small y. Now to form, now these four gametes are formed. So you get answer, that is option A. But you should understand how these gametes are formed, because this capital R small r is present on another pair of chromosome, and this Y capital Y and small y is present on the another pair of chromosome. So this capital R will go with the Y, then this capital R will go with again with the small y, then small r can go with the Y, and small r can go with the small y. So we want to form a gamete, then fork line method can work. In fork line method you can use capital R can go or small r can go. With capital R it can go capital Y or small y, and with the small r also it can go capital Y or small y. So the gamete will be capital R capital Y, capital R small y, small r capital Y, and small r small y. So these four gametes are formed in 1:1:1:1 ratio. So answer A is the correct answer. Question 72 asks that a color blind man, that is XCY, a color blind man marries a daughter of a color blind person, of a color blind person. Color blind person means it is a male or it is a father. Now its daughter can be XCX carrier, so it is a carrier female. Now if we go with this, there is a two type of gamete will form, XC and Y. Here also two type of gamete will form, XC and X. Now if we take a cross, then it will form XC XC, then XC X, then XC Y, then X and Y. So it is a color blind female, it is a carrier female, it is a color blind male, and it is a normal male. So now if we go with the options, option A is given as none of the daughter are color blind. Daughter are color blind, yes, so it is an incorrect option. Option B is given as all the sons are color blind. So two sons are there, out of this only 50% are color blind, one is normal, so it is also incorrect. C is given as all the daughters are colorblind. No, in out of the two daughters, one is carrier, one is colorblind, so all daughters are not colorblind. And option D is given as half of their sons are colorblind. So yes, two sons are there, out of this 50%, that is half of them are colorblind. So it is a correct answer. So D is the correct answer for this. Question 73 asks that one of the following is not true to hemophilia. Now if we talk about hemophilia, hemophilia is X-linked recessive disorder, as we have discussed in some of the question before also. So it is X-linked disorder, and there is a deficiency of a clotting factor of blood, due to which what happens, there is a defect in the particularly hemoglobin, particularly blood clotting. So if we go with the option A, it is a royal disease. Yes, it was found in the royal family of England, so it is known as royal disease. B, bladder disease. Yes, blood loss occur due to the clotting deficiency. C, it is X-linked recessive. Yes, and option D is given as Y-linked. It is not Y-linked, it is X-linked, so it is not correct. So D is the correct answer, that it is not true for hemophilia. Question 74 asks that if a homozygous red flower plant, that is capital R capital R, that is a homozygous red flower plant, is crossed with the homozygous white flower plant, that is a small r small r, the offspring would be, so in this gamete will be capital R and here gamete will be small r, so fusion will occur and capital R small r will be formed. Now if it follows the laws of dominance, then it is a red flower. Okay, so all the offspring which are obtained in F1 are rate flowered according to the law of dominance. So all rate flowered option is option C. So C is the correct answer. Next is question 75. Question 75 asks that example of qualitative inheritance. Example of qualitative inheritance. Now, qualitative inheritance means qualitative inheritance means those disorder which show Mendelian pattern of inheritance. So all the Mendelian disorder or genetic disorder are considered as a qualitative disorder. So if we go with the option A, option A shows a color of skin. Now color of skin is example of polygenic inheritance, and polygenic inheritance does not follow a Mendelian inheritance. It is a type of quantitative inheritance. That is a type of quantitative inheritance. So this is incorrect. Now option B is given as color blindness. So color blindness is a X-linked recessive disorder and it is a Mendelian disorder. So yes, it is a qualitative inheritance. Option C is given as Klinefelter syndrome. Now Klinefelter syndrome is not a Mendelian disorder. It is a chromosomal disorder. And this chromosomal disorder are not inheritable. So they do not show a qualitative inheritance. And D is given as alkaptonuria. Now alkaptonuria is an inborn error of metabolism, but it is a autosomal recessive disorder. And this autosomal recessive disorder show Mendelian disorder. So this autosomal recessive disorder, that is a Mendelian disorder, so it is also showing a Mendelian inheritance. So in this question, option B and option D both are the correct answer.